That seems to work. Let's put our feet on the pedals so that we don't get out of control. And unpause. This is a funny thing, even when it's paused, you see the rotor animation in this one. But yeah, we're going to be flying with our door gunner here, who's going to do some shooting for us. And I think we're at Beslan. Yeah, Beslan Airfield. And we've got some people at a crossroads here who are possibly going to get some reinforcements, so I'm going to go investigate that. Then they have a little base there and another little base there, so we've got different waypoints. And you can see that I have my GPS. I'll zoom in on it. You'll see that we'll be able to see our waypoints in there, so it helps for navigation. Because we have this new thing here, the iPad, that I hadn't really tried much before. You can see where you are on the map, but you see a little bit better where you need to go with the GPS, so I still use both. So there you go. So hopefully I'll keep this under control. One of the things I've noticed, and then maybe I'll mention it, is that with the controls here, sometimes like I get inputs that go whoop, whoop, like towards the front or towards the back. It's like the joystick wants to control itself. It's not following my inputs. It's just getting, I don't know, inputs from God somewhere. And so I had to play with a lot of my bindings. And might have solved a few things by assigning things that I didn't need to assign to certain axes, but there's still some axes that are available on my stick, and when I hit them by accident, it tries to control the rudders or something, and it's not assigned to that, so there's still a few kinks to iron out, I guess. But it's flyable, so let's go have fun a little bit with this. Oh, and yeah, this is what the helicopter looks like. I took a Royal Army version because it fits well with the colors of the area here. And so that's what we're going to be flying there. So let's unpause. So we've got this. Try to get it airborne slowly under control. Say hello to our little crewman here in front. Looks like he's bending down not to get hit. So if we go look on the screen here, if I reduce the range, we'll see our waypoints. Got T1, T2, T3, and then land back here. So that's going to be what we'll use for flying around. Might actually reduce the range even more. One of the things I should have done before taking off is setting up north up, enter, and clear. That way as you turn the helicopter like this, you can see that it turns the GPS as well. So I guess we're going to head for T1 in that direction. And I've set my controls here for that, so he's going to be fire at will. Good to go. Good to go, alright. see on my flight plan that I'm a little bit south of it, so I'm gonna try to intercept the pink line there. I'm trying to get to a crossroads there. I think it's where all the power lines meet up. Reports that indicate an insurgent convoy to the northeast of the road. Intercept the bloody wankers. Alright, we'll do that. Seems pretty quiet at the convoy here. I see civilian traffic. Was about. Oh! We're getting shot at. At least the gunner saw it even before I did. Let's give him a better firing solution there. I think he's got the. Shooting in that direction. Looks like some vehicles blowing up. To figure out what's the thing in the field there that we see with the smoke, but there it is, it disappeared. Alright, so that's taken care of. We'll go to T2, which is a little bit further down the road. That's the first enemy base that might be there. Oh yeah, we do have an ammo count like in the Huey when the gunner shoots. Pretty fast, 130. get a sensation of speed. Shot at. We all good here. Ooh, nice explosion there. It's funny that it doesn't shoot the tents, but it's just a tent. Alright. So let's move on to the next one. Follow the forest line there, it's going to be following more or less the flight plan we want to take. we're out of ammo. Yeah, ammo zero. Well, that means let's head home. We'll come back for those guys some other time. Maybe when we get home, we could actually reload and come back. Play a little bit of cowboy and go under the lines. Yeehaw. You can see on the iPad that Beslan is right in front of us, and you can also see that land is the waypoint that we've got set up there. And there in the distance we can see the runway. Let's go say hello to the blokes at the Hercules. back to where we took off from. Go. Let's see now. Can we rearm this? I don't think we need any new fuel. But the guns. Gun ammo. There.
Request rearming. Copy.
Got some ammo right there behind the truck. Ah, see that the ammo has gone up.
Rearming complete.
Good, thank you. Alright, let's head back to the last waypoint where we still had a few guys. Overstress the engine, but still we want to get some speed going. This time going above. Going under. There's a line in the sand. There's nothing there. Maybe it's Speedy Gonzales. I don't know. It's weird. This area here looks clear. Here. All right, I hope you enjoyed the little display with the mini guns. I'm just happy that I was able to fly the Gazelle today, because earlier in the day, it wasn't working too well. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed